Tonight, though, celebrations for our history-making winner being soured somewhat by controversy. Olympic boss John Coates sparked sharp criticism for publicly scolding Anastasia Palaszczuk, seemingly ordering her to attend Tokyo's opening ceremony. But tonight he's revealing it was all part of a plan to help the Premier break her promise and see the show.
An Olympics power broker and the powerless Premier.
You are going to the opening ceremony. I'm still the deputy chair of the Canada Leadership Group.
Disguised as an order.
And all of you have got to get along there and understand the traditional parts of that.
It appeared rude.
None of you are staying behind and hiding in your rooms, all right?
No one says no to John.
Then, embarrassing.
I don't want to offend anybody, so...
But John Coates says what it really was set up. Annoyed at the abuse sent his way online. Unprofessional, misogynistic, out of line, mansplaining. The AOC boss called Nine newspapers and admitted the ruse. The plan was I was going to fix it. I fixed it. I was taking the heat off her. The media in Brisbane have been giving her a hard time, saying she shouldn't go to the opening ceremony, but she had to go. We all came back and had a drink all night in my room to celebrate. She thanked me.
And I'm calling it for what it is. Premier Anastasia Palaszczuk is a liar.
Because a week ago, the Premier said this.
I am not attending any events whatsoever.
And despite some saving face...
I think what she was referring to was she wouldn't go to any sporting events.
The reality is her office said she would not be going to the ceremony, even calling journalists just this week to say any suggestion otherwise was wrong. So today was a change of tune.
We actually have to put an opening ceremony on and a closing ceremony, and the scale is going to be huge. There is an expectation now that all three of us attend.
The Premier, the Federal Sport Minister and the Lord Mayor, who says he always intended to go.
I think it's important that we're all there in person.
With, of course, John Coates, who sums up today's roller coaster with this. The Premier and I have a long-standing and very successful relationship, he says. We both know the spirit of my remarks.
Now, it's worth pointing out the Lord Mayor first got his invitation to the opening ceremony weeks ago while the Premier was saying things like she would be flying into Tokyo doing business and flying straight back again. So something has changed, clearly, along the way. Meanwhile, the next question is how the Premier will be spending 2 weeks in hotel quarantine when she returns to Queensland, and Melissa, her office, is adamant tonight it will be in a hotel where thousands of other Queenslanders have spent isolation.
Adam, thank you.